these, just to make abundantly spreading my love. But you say you're not a king yet, took a king to die for you to die for them. But you say you're not a queen yet, took a righteous one to stand beside them. It's almost like washing your hands with power I've given you. Understand that because I am who I am, the great I am, you are my people. And I designed you to walk in my light. But how could you ever portray to be Christ-like when you don't even know your name? King, queen. It took him a while to fully grasp who he was, because for the longest he only knew what his neighborhood said he was supposed to be, that 17-year-old dropout, 17 began the equivalent of a high school diploma, a GED, because where's the necessity of education who reside on the streets. And just as a sidebar, any person who wants to be potentially successful with a profession of selling weed or any other legal substance for that fact and have customs 50, you have to figure them out. But Postmarks was laughing, so he couldn't even sell a net. I'm just saying, his mother was too young to fully know how to raise him. His father was genetically born with the disease to have sex with a woman, and as soon as the term pregnancy came up, that was his cue to leave. So in her mind, the damage is already done. There was no point trying to teach her son a different way, a genuine hearse, because morals and values is not something you can find in the book. It's obvious that this is a continuation of the generational curse. So he began practicing that boy that was genuine first and name later with son was so fleshly hurting you to make himself happy. He thought with his genitals before he thought like his daddy. Generational curse. That a wannabe man who lived off that naive girl who dumbfoundedly let him in that nameless king, who was not only painful and sensing things, living a lifestyle that was in every way contrary to his spiritual being, yet he is still a king. It might sound odd, but oddly enough, that's who God created him to be. Follow me. Mr. Stroop being led to believe she was the definition of ugly. Never searching for God, only usual when she became useful. So for every teenage boy who could whisper something sweet is that he second, her knees became a little more weak. And every time she decided to open her legs and her spirit, the devil became a little more deep. She said she would not be beautiful enough because in her mind to be that, you have to be pure. So if you're ever in a situation where your virgin is falsely taken, there's no way to get it back. You can look at a version you own today who is ready to give it away. But somehow her mind used to never be as beautiful as that. Not to add that her thick was off track and she couldn't stand straight because her daddy was the one to put a flat on the back. So to a certain degree, I can understand. But understand that no man deserves anything from you for free. Queen, higher standards, literary thriving temples that was dangling in between, I can identify with you if your jewel was taken. But understand that substituting a word with the world is no justification. Queen, unknowingly, she was a painful and sensing things, living a lifestyle that was in every way contrary to her spiritual being, yet she is still a queen. It might sound odd, but oddly enough, that's who God created her to be. Follow me. It doesn't matter what decisions you made. It doesn't matter where or how you've been raised. God has created a life for you to walk in, is purposely giving you a name. King, queen. As boys grow up to your men, and your men find that your king, understand that daddy, your child, and father one are two totally different things. But if your mentality is messed enough, then you would even gaze in the act initially until you have found that queen that you promised to love, respect, and cherish for eternity. And even though now you should, understand that eventually you'll want a queen. So don't waste your time to satisfy your flesh temporarily and miss out on your blessing. And to my queens, it's time to raise the standards. Nowadays, we make it too easy. See, it's easy to let a guy come into your life based off the sweet nothings he's feeding you that are all equated to lies, eventually giving away his act and watch him ease away. Fly, queen. You deserve nothing less than a king. Not a boy trying to imitate over the grown man still trying to figure out what it means. But a king is not based off the misery of things, but it's based off the mentality. But as a teen, before you worry about a guy, worry about yourself. Because as you're perfecting yourself in God, prioritizing your life and making your list of do's, you won't have to look search or worry. Because that king will certainly find you. Queen, king, thank you.